this is what we're doing this week now. I know I've been funny, I've been hilarious, but we're in towards the end of the year, and there's just things that I want to discuss, and one of them is about editing your work and picking out the right shot for you, not for your client. For you, I think it's crucial. If you guys haven't seen it yet, go on kelby1.com and look at it's all about the edit. So this is basically it's all about the edit. But I want to show you how. So I've shot I don't know how many people, and I shoot I don't know how many people a week. And you know how many make it in my portfolio? There's like I've shot over 20,000 people. There's like not even 100 people on the website. You know, so it's very I'm very picky. I want you to be picky, and I want you to be choosing shots for a reason, and I want them to be perfect for your artist inside, like what you want to see. I don't go by what other people want or tell me. I go by what I want to see. So what I'm going to do is I am going to show you a screenshot of this entire operation. So this is Sam, and Sam has 254 images. Everybody always asks me how many images I keep. I get to 100 and then I start to slow it down, unless the person's amazing and I'm having a good time with them and I really like them. And Sam I happen to really like. I thought he was really cool and he had a good look. So to be honest, everything, for an image to go on my website, everything has to be perfect. I need perfect expression, I need to love the lighting, I need to love what he's wearing, I need to love the whole look of it, the hair for him. There's not that many guys I get in with long hair, so I would like to put Sam on the website. But I have 254 images that I have to go through. So the first thing I do, I don't even worry, I look at the style. Like, I don't know if I like the jacket with the V. I probably wouldn't put this on the site. He liked it, I shot it, I thought it's okay, cool. I don't like the V by itself, so I'm automatically blown by it. I have a gray background. I'm probably not gonna go gray. I know I shot them on the black background, so I might just go to those. I don't like bright blue on a white background, but he wanted it commercially, it's fine. A black V is fine if I did like these, but I wanna go back. Look how fast I'm going through these. I want you to look at the hair. Look at the hair as we go. The hair changes from shot to shot. There's different subtleties of what the hair is doing. I'll also look for the right hair that I want. So I want the hair to look a particular way. I want him to be wearing what I want. And so far, since I know I definitely would not use one of these shots for my site. I'm not gonna use one with a blue shirt on. It's not my style. I don't like that. And it's just not, it doesn't hit my speed. So if what they're wearing doesn't hit my speed, like I picked all this stuff for him to wear, like I like the black B, but I probably wouldn't use that either. The blue like jean shirt I like, it's on a gray background. It's okay, I don't love it. I can look this fast. I don't like what his hair's doing in these, so I probably wouldn't pick these. Let me see, this is more the look. So I'm loving the black pro board these days, and how I shoot a little subtle hint of light through it. I'm liking his expression in here and the attitude change as he gets further along in the shoot. These I'm gonna think about. These I like, because I have that back in black. And this guy is at the actor's studio. I had him do a ponytail because I thought if he ever cuts his hair or his agent asks, we have it. So we did a ponytail on white and on black. But I don't love the ponytail. Let me just see. So I'm definitely going to use one of the black background with the hair down. So that's 254 images that I just nixed down to, because I'm only going to use one for my site, and I want the best look, the best outfit, and what I want. And right now I've got 36 to choose from. That's how many are in the black background. So I've got 36 of them. And I'm gonna go through and I'm just gonna five spot the ones I like. I don't think the black background for Sam he's got long hair in the black background. I want it to be serious. I don't need a big smile on him. I want the light to be perfect. I like that one. I'm looking for expression though. I like that. I don't need the big smile. Plus he had Invisalign, so he has those little nubs on his teeth, which you could take off. If you see the little nubs on people's teeth, they have Invisalign. A lot of times they'll take it out and they won't tell me. I'll be like, you got Invisalign? Yeah, how'd you know that? Well, you got those little nubs on there. Anyway, so I'm going through. I'm going to do a quick run. If I see something that pops out at me, this has nothing to do with what Sam wants or might use. Nothing. I don't know. They never pick the same one I pick. usually. I'm looking for something strange, unusual, something in the expression that hits, something in the lighting that's a little different, maybe a little hint of a smell, a little brow action, little something, something that kicks off a little, spurs a little something in me. I like, there's some more brow pressure. And I actually like, he's, all right, so at the end, that one's got some intensity to it. That one I really like, little smirk. I don't mind that, no, no. So what I'm doing is I'm just gonna give the ones fives that I might wanna use. And if the shot's not there, then it's not there, and I won't use it. If I didn't get the shot, then I'm not gonna use Sam. But if I got the shot, I'm gonna use him. So I'm going through, I'm using my eye, what my artist thinks inside, right? What's one that's gonna be interesting? I don't wanna miss the shot either. Like if it's there, Sam was cool. I liked working with Sam. So I want Sam on my site. You know, that's the other thing. Never put somebody that you don't get along with on your site. All right, now I'm done. I'm done. I got rid of the 36. I narrowed it down to 10 shots. I marked all the ones fives. 10 shots. Here we go. One, two. I'll just go through that one or that one. I like this one a little bit better. That one or that one. I like this one a little bit better, but he's got a little eye situation going on. That one I like a little bit better. It's better in the eye. This one's more interesting. That one's interesting. All right. Look, I'm narrowing it down. It's between these two. I like those better than that one. This one maybe. That's a little smirk. That one's really good. All right, I got five now. One, two, three, I got five. Do I like this one or this one? And it's all on vibe. This is apples to apples, guys. Apples to apples, it's up to you. You gotta pick. And you gotta narrow it down. Yeah, so I'm looking for something. Something that hits me. Maybe the crop is better with the shoulders like this. I like the crop, I like the eyes above center line. You guys all know that. I like where he's placed with the shoot through in the back on this one, but he's got a little smirk. He's a little meaner here. I don't like the back shoulder ever going down. So what I would do, I might change this and twist him a little bit in the crop on that one. But I like this. I wanna see what his face is telling me when I'm in there. He's got a hint of a smile. He's got a little something going on. He's got brow pressure, that's for sure. Here he's overdoing it a touch. I like that better. I really like this one though. I really like the crop on this better than this. So I'm gonna go get rid of this. It's between this one and this one. And I like the lookability in both of them, but I get a little more juice out of this one. The crop is a little bit better, how I'm tighter a little bit, the whole situation. So I'm gonna go with this. 194 is the shot. Now, all I did, I zoomed through. You saw me do it. Like, I know immediately, style-wise, I want the black background. Boom, I want the shirt with the jacket with the collared shirt. And I'm going with that shot, which for me has the lookability, and that's the winner number 194. Sam is done. Done. Now we're gonna do a girl. I'm gonna blast through. I'm gonna show you the situation. And it's based on style. So go style first. So we're gonna go into Kaya's. Where's Kaya? Kaya's gorgeous. But I know that I like Kaya with her hair up better than her hair down. Kaya's beautiful. I gotta get her on my site. But I know she wanted gray background. I think she looked better on the white background. I liked the hair got a little changed throughout the shoot. The hair up's gorgeous. I love the hair up. This is her on the Oliphant background, which I like, but I don't know. I just think this was the look I liked. Now, I like the blue shirt. I like the blue shirt, a little messy, kind of sloppy. I thought it was cool. Oh man, she's gorgeous too. I liked her whole look. So this is probably the look I'm gonna go with, and it has to do with the shirt and the hair. Let me just see. Let me just double check, because here she is on the black background and she looks good, but I don't know that I need her to fall into black like that. It depends if I needed a woman like this on black, although these are gorgeous pictures. I really, my favorite thing is the hair up on white in that little top, although these are really nice. I don't know, it might take more time for me to go through this because these are gorgeous. Now she's on the gray. Now depending, oh, these look amazing. Oh geez. I don't know. Let's just see where I went with it. Now she got 308 pictures. So like I said, people I like, I overshoot. If I love them, like how could you not overshoot a woman like this? How could you not? You gotta do it. But I think the most powerful, most beautiful shots to me were with the hair up and the blue shirt. So I'm gonna zip right back to that. So for me, it's based on these, and then I'm just gonna go through and I'm just gonna mark them. And I'm just gonna go off vibe. It's a little bit of crop. I could still crop in tighter. It's more vibe than anything else. I'm looking for something special, right guys? I'm just looking to see what I get. It's the lookability. What do I get out of the shot? What's Kaya giving me that is gonna be more interesting than one shot over the next? One thing I really like to do is that centered straight down the middle shot, and her face looks good like that, so I'm probably gonna wanna go with a shot like that. Her smile's cute, she's beautiful. She went to my high school. How weird is that? I didn't figure that. I figured that out mid-shoot. It's very strange. It's like crazy. Kind of like that one. But I do like her straight on. So I'm looking for a straight on shot because I know these are gorgeous. This is the shots in here. Okay, there we go. So now I've got 7 shots. I've narrowed it down to 7. I like the hint of the smile better than the serious one. This one goes to 4. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna use her. It's a cute smile, but she's so beautiful and I like her jawline and everything straight on. So I'm not gonna use this one. This one's a little darker, so I'd probably open it up like this. But I do like that energy. I like this one over this one. I like that one. I like that one over that one. It's apples to apples, guys. All right, so here are the 3. And I think this one's gonna win. I'm just gonna open it up a little bit. I like her standing up straight like this a little bit better, but I love that. I love this vibe. This is the shot. For me, this is the shot. So it's more of about a vibe, and I can open this up to match this kind of exposure later. So I'm going with 105. So first, which look that you shot was your favorite look? If it's gotta be, like, what's your favorite look? This shirt I like the best, that's gonna be. I liked her hair up the best. I like the way Francisco does the hair a little messy and when he puts it up. I like that you can see a couple pieces hanging from the back. I like her expression, I like her straight on. I like the light wrap around her cheeks. And that's, now I could go back and forth like crazy. Both of these are beautiful. And it's apples to apples. Like if I use this shot, or if I use this shot, or if I use this shot, nobody's gonna know the difference except me. I'm the only one that's gonna know. Kaya might know, but she, you know, it's up to me. So which shot gives the best vibe? And I think this one's cool because she looks more of a badass and these are friendlier, but we're not going friendly with Kaya, we're going badass. So this is the one we're gonna use. It's gonna be number 105 and that's gonna go on my site. So that's the way I do it. Always style, style, style. Your style, not their style, your style. It has to be your style. Never pick a shot for, never pick a shot for that they pick unless it's the same one that you pick. Unless you pick it, you gotta pick it for a reason. I pick these, you know, based off, I never ask anybody. It's my, I want you to develop your eye, and I want you to think during the shoot, which shot, I always want you to shoot for your portfolio, which means you gotta look at their wardrobe and pick out which shot is for your portfolio, which means if they come in, I had a girl, a woman came in with a huge pearl necklace on about an hour ago, and I shot one shot, I said, look at that. And she goes, yeah. I said, don't you think the pearl necklace is a little much? She goes, yeah, I could take it off. I said, yeah, why don't you take it off? Boom, took it off. I'm never gonna put a big pearl necklace in my portfolio. I'm not gonna use her in my portfolio. She was a corporate job that wasn't done with my makeup artist, that I just don't use those. I'm very particular about what I use. But you get a sense of it. Don't put everybody in your portfolio that you shoot. Go through style first, hair and clothing. Make sure the hair looks right to you, clothing. Then we're looking at expression. And obviously, if they have a look that you want, the look's already there. Their appearance is already, I want to put that person in my portfolio. Why do you want to put one person over another? Depends upon lookability, not about attractiveness. Now, I do put attractive people in my portfolio because I like to get lookability out of attractive people anyway. If I have a charactery look, I love them in my portfolio if I got the lookability. If I didn't get the lookability, they don't go in my portfolio anyway. Nothing to do with the level of attractiveness. You know, it's got more to do with the shot I get. So I want you to go through style, hair, expression. It's got to be based on style. That was all based on style. I picked, and when I knew she was in that shirt and that look, I overshot it. I shot it more than any other look because I knew that was the one for me. So figure out which one's for you and go for it. Thank you. This was a good week. I'm editing my pictures. I'm gonna edit my pictures. They're gonna go in my portfolio. They're gonna go on my website. Guys, if you like this video, you're absolutely gonna love what I have going on over at the Headshot Crew. It's an absolute smorgasbord of material just like this that I've been working on for the last 10 years. So click the link below, check it out, and do not forget to subscribe to this channel. I got stuff coming out just for you.